we'll discuss about the Snell's law. What is the Snell's law? According to the Snell's law, there are the light which is passing from one optical medium to another optical medium, where it bent and what types of the angle is formed. Okay, now let's talk about the Snell's law. Snell's law, first Snell's law is saying that when the light ray travels from a rare medium to the denser medium, it bends towards the normal. That means angle of incidence is always equal to angle of refractions. I will show you here one by one the diagram. Look the carefully. According to the Snell's law, what is saying? First is, this is a denser medium. Okay. Now this is the normal. Okay. First is saying, when the ray of light travels from rare medium to denser medium, this is the rare medium and this is the denser medium. Means when incidence ray passing from rare medium to denser medium, it bends towards the normal. What is saying? It bends towards the normal. It bends towards the normal. Light will pass like this, but it will not pass like this. It bends towards the normal. It means the angle of incidence is greater than angle of diffraction. Means this is the angle of incidence is always greater than angle of refraction. This sign is always greater than this. First, Snell was saying that angle of incidence is always greater than angle of refraction. Here we have seen in this figure, the incidence ray is appraised when it passes from rare medium to the denser medium, it bends towards the normal. And now the angle of this sine I is always greater than angle of sine R. This is the sine R, always greater. So according to the Snell's law, the first one is when a light is passing from a rare medium to the denser medium, yes, it means at that time the angle of incidence is always greater than angle of refraction. Now second one, what is saying? When the light is passing from the denser medium to rare medium, it bends away from the normal. Now let's see another figure. In figure number 2, अब अर्को फिगरमा हेर्ने फोर फिगरमा के भनेको थियो, जब इन्सिडेन्स रे आउँछ हैन र बेन्ड गर्छ पास द नर्मल तिर, तर सेकेन्ड लो व्हाट इज सेइङ, दिस इज द एयर मीडियम एन्ड दिस इज द डेन्सर मीडियम. यस, व्हेन एन्ड एनी इन्सिडेन्स रे, व्हेन द रे, दिस इज द नाउ इन्सिडेन्स रे, डेन्सर मीडियम टु रेयर मीडियम, इट बेंड्स अवे फ्रॉम द normal. It will become like this, but it will away from the normal. The ray of light comes from the denser medium to rare medium, it bends away from the normal. Look the carefully once again picture. I will show you. This is a, okay, this is a one incidence ray, okay, which is coming from our denser medium towards the air medium. It means it will, this way it will go, but it will pass like this. It means it goes towards the away from the normal. Second law. So here angle of this incidence is here angle of incidence. It means here in air medium, it means that angle of incidence is always smaller than angle of refraction. Here angle of incidence is always greater than angle of refractions. It means, so in the third way, in the third, what is saying, when a light is passing from through the normal, it does not bend. In the third figure, what is saying, when the light is coming from, this is a rare denser medium and this is a, when the ray of light is coming from perpendicularly, it does not bend. So according to the third law of the inversion, when the ray of the light is coming perpendicularly, yes, at that time it does not bend anywhere, it comes perpendicular to the it passes. So there are the three laws of the Snell's law. Okay, thank you. Now let's talk about the effect of refractions. Here are several effects of refractions. Today we will discuss about in two or three effects of the refractions. So first effect is when a statistic appears bends towards when it is partially immersed into the water. It means take one long stick and keep that long statistic into the water. Then what will happen? You will see that in the water, you will see the air, that stick bends. But actually, that stick is not bent. Yes? You can also do this experiment in your home also. Take one statistics and immerse half part of the sticks into the water. What you will feel? You will see that the half of the sticks which is inside the water, that is inside the denser medium, that we have seen that it bends, but actually it is bent not. Means this is a statistics and I have taken, and when I immerse into the water, I have seen that this is my eye, this is my eye, and when I observe from here, I have seen that the sticks is like this bending, like in this way it bends, but actually the sticks does not bend. This is what is the reason. This is due to the refraction of light. What is only one reason? Due to the refraction of light. You have seen the light which is immersed, yes, inside this denser medium, it is away from the normal. It means when it is passing, the emergence ray just appears here. You have seen that the stick is bending like this, but actually it does not bend. So here, when an object is in the denser medium is observed in denser medium, when any object is what observed from the rare medium, जब हामी कुनै rare medium बाट कुनै वस्तुहरु denser medium लाई हेर्छौ, denser medium भएका वस्तुहरुलाई हेर्छौ भने it is appears like as the less depth, र less depth पनि देखिन्छ, थोरै depth लाग्छ कि माथिमै छ depth, उसको पानी थोरै छ, तर that is not the real, that is the apparent depth. What is that? Apparent depth. But when we the depth and the actual depth, that is called what? Real depth. The actual depth, that is called the real depth, and the depth which we have seen from denser medium towards the rare medium towards the denser medium, that is apparent depth. That is the not the real depth in water. Now I am going to tell you one example. म एउटा एक्जाम्पल भन्न गइरहेको छु, सुन्नु. पानी पोखरीमा होइन, जब हामी हाम्रो आँखाले पोखरीमा हेर्छौँ, हामीले के लाग्छ कि त्यहाँ थोरै पानी छ, होइन? किन हामी के गर्छौँ, रेयर मिडियमबाट डेन्सर मिडियमतिर हेरिरहेको हुन्छौँ, हामीले के लाग्छ, पोखरीमा धेरै पानी छ, थोरै पानी छ जस्तो लाग्छ. तर हामी जब हामी त्यसमा भित्र जान्छौँ भने हाम्रो पानी धेरै महसुस हुन्छ. यसको अर्थ के हो? जुन माथिबाट हामी हेरेको थियो त्यो एभरेज डेप्थ थियो, र जुन पानीभित्र गएर जुन गराइ नाप्यो, द्याट इज वाट रियल डेप्थ. यो के कारणले भयो? यो सबैभन्दा पहिले एउटै हो, रिफ्र्याक्सन अफ लाइट. दिस इज ड्यु टु द रिफ्र्याक्सन अफ लाइट. आई हेभ सोन यु हेयर, मैले एउटा इक्जाम्पल पनि देखाएको छु. एउटा लट्ठी लिने, सिधा लट्ठीलाई पानीमा राख्ने, पानीमा राखिसकेपछि के हुन्छ, त्यो बेन्ड हुन्छ. तर वास्तविक स्टिक बेन्ड भएको हुन्छ हुँदैन, हामीलाई के लाग्छ, bend, that is the apparent bending, but that is the real not, it is not really bent. This is only due to what? Refraction of light. Ani aru kuro hami pani aru herchho pokhri ma jun thama pani a machha dekhchho bhane vastavik tyo thama machha hudaina, kina jun thama hami machha herireko hunchho tyo hamro apparent image huncha. Okay, that is the apparent image, but actually at that place there is no fish. What we have seen. So when we are catching the fish, we have to catch the where or while we hit the fish with a spears or anything, at that time you should hit it in the sideways. Okay? Now, another is, what another examples I will show you. And at the same as, we can give the another example effects upon our swimming pool appears much slower than its actual is. It means, just I have already told you, means in the whatever you have seen in the swimming pool, yes, the real depth, that is not the actually real, that is the apparent depth. And when you will go in the swimming pool, yes, at the time it is the what? You will find the real depth. Means, in this example, we will see that take a bucket of water and keep it at, keep a coin. Here is a coin. Okay, the from the coin, the ray which is comes out from denser medium to rarer medium. As you know, this is bends away from the normal, and this is our eyes, and we will see like this. We will see the coin is here. This is the real, this is apparent. Yes, but actually, where is the coin? Here is the coin, but we will see, here is the coin. This is due to the what? Reflection of light. So, there are the various effects of the reflection of light. You will study one by one in your home also. And if you have any problem, then please comment to me. Morning students, today we will discuss about the electronic configurations from the camera, from the matrix appear. In the matter, there is the electronic configuration is a separate separate. So, what is the electronic configurations? Electronic configuration means the distribution of the electrons in a different cell according to the increasing its or size. So, here means electronic configuration means the distribution. It means the systematic distribution of the electrons in the various orbit or the energy level around the nucleus of that of atom, that is called electronic configurations. This, first of all, this electronic configurations was postponed or proposed by Bohr and Biot. Bohr and Biot in 1921 AD. In 1921 AD, yes, Bohr and Biot has prepared. Yes, he has given that the rules and the rules for the what distribution of the what electronic configurations. So in the electronic configurations, you have seen that in the at the center it lies is the nucleus. What is the nucleus? The center of the what? The center of the element that is called what nucleus. In that nucleus, yes, the proton and the neutron are lies, and inside this around the electrons are revolving its and the temperature is revolving. So now we have seen how much elements, how much electrons can we keep in our different cell. Cell means what? Path. Means how many electrons we can keep in a single, in a different number of what? Cell. So the first cell is the KLMN, KLMNO. In this way, the word, it is the name of the word element, word cells. So this, the number of the word electrons are kept according to the rule of 2n square. What is the? According to the 2n square means how much maximum number of the electrons are used. How much maximum number of the electrons are used in a cell. Okay, today I will show you now how we can keep the number of the cells in a different orbit or the energy levels. So now, the first cell K, L, M, N. It means you have seen in the first cell According to the rule, you have seen 2n square. 2n square means 1 represent the number of cell. 1 represent what? Number. Means this is a 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of orbit we can say. Orbit. N represent the number of orbit. In the first cell, in the K cell, how much electrons have been used? So 2 into 1 square. How much? 2 into 1, it means 2. It means the first cell has the capacity to use the maximum number of electrons is 2. Okay, and in second and same as 2n square, it means 2 into 2 square, it means 2 into 4, it means 8. Means the it has the capacity of having the 8 electrons, maximum 8 electrons. In n cell, at the same as you can do it in the same by using the formula 2n square rule, 2 into 3. Where I am bringing from the 3? This is the number of what? Cell. It means what? Number of cell. 3 square. It means 2 into 9. Ag. We can use Ag. And n cell as the same as we can use 2n square rule, 2 into 4 square, 2 into 16. 32. It means it has the maximum number of keeping of the what electrons in the different cells, has the maximum number of electrons in the different cells. While we are classifying, yes, we can, while we are constructing the electronic configurations, it is a very important for the distribution of the electrons. Means how much electrons have been used in a different cells. Okay, so I will do you the some of the examples I will show you, and I will draw also the diagram of the. Let's take one examples. How much electrons we can use in a suppose sodium. What is the electronic number of what is the atomic number of sodium? Is 11. Okay, and first cell. This is the nucleus, center of the nucleus, which lies in proton, positive and neutron. This is a cell, first cell, K cell, L, M. So what is the, how much element should be used in K cell? K, L, M. What is the capacity of the first cell is? 2. How much? 2. And second one is 8. So we have to use 8. Now 8 and 2, 10. And what is the remaining? 1. In M cell, there is only 1 electron. So in the first cell, we have to use 2 electrons. This is the electron, 2 electrons. In second cell, we have to use 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. What is the capacity of the second cell? Little cell? 8 electrons. And third one is only 1. 1. In this way, it can exist in the different cells. The electrons are stable in the different cells. Okay. Now, we'll just another example. We'll take the calcium. What is the atomic number of calcium? 20. Okay, now we have to do the electronic configurations of the calcium. So the first cell K, L, M, N. Let's do it. First have the capacity of 2, second has the capacity of 8, and another is capacity of how much? According to 2n square root, 3 square root 9 to the 18. It has the capacity of 18, but it can fulfill its octet by taking the only 8 electrons. What is octet and duplet? I will tell you some letters. So it can be what? It can be required only 8 electrons, then it fulfills its octet rule. Okay, after that 1 to 18, yes, and 2 is remaining. Means outermost shell, how much electrons is required? 2 electrons. Here you will see This is a proton and neutron. This is our first cell, 2 electrons. Second cell, 8 electrons. Four, five, six, seven, 8 electrons. In 8 cell, M cell, it requires the one 8 electrons, but it has the capacity of having 18 electrons, but it can fulfill its duplet octet having the 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And last one cell is N cell, which have the 2 electrons at the outer side. Okay, in this way we can draw the atomic structures also, and we can distribute the electronic configurations also. So what is the octet and the duplet, and what is the octet rule and the duplet rule, I will tell you that. What is the duplet? Duplet means the presence of the electrons on the outermost K cell. The presence of the how much? The presence of the electron on the outermost cell, that is called duplet. It means when these electrons in the first cell, yes, when it is fulfilled by the 2 electrons, yes, that is called duplet. And duplet rule means the tendency of the atom of the attaining 2 electrons on the K cell, that is called duplet rule. What is duplet? The presence of the electrons in the first cell, yes, the presence of the electrons on the outermost cell, in outermost K cell, but in the first cell is K cell, has the capacity of having the first electrons, that is called duplet. And duplet rule is means the tendency of having the 2 electrons. Something about 2 electrons only have the capacity and the tendency to gain, that is called duplet rule. Another is octet and octet rule. What is that octet and octet rule? Now, octet. What is that octet? The presence of the 8 electrons in the outermost cell of that atom is called octet. It means in the K cell, in the outer cell, what is it? How much electrons will be required? 8. If there is 8, it can fulfill its octet. It no need. Means, as the same as octet rule, the tendency of an atom of gaining 8 electrons on the outermost cell, either by sharing or transferring of that atoms, that is called octet rule. So there is a duplet and octet. Duplet means the tendency of having the 2 electrons in the first cell, K cell, and in octet it has a tendency of obtaining what? 8 electrons. Either they are sharing or by transferring, they have to fulfill the 8 electrons. That is called the what? Octet rule. So what is the difference between octet and duplet? So once again I am saying octet. Octet means the tendency of having 2 electrons, that is duplet. And the tendency of having 8 electrons, either by sharing or by the transferring, that is called duplet, octet. So there is the octet and the duplet is the difference. Octet means having the 8 electrons, tendency of the 8 electrons, and duplet means having the 2 electrons. So in this way we can make the different types of the electronic configurations, and we have to make the different number of the atomic numbers. Around the atomic number you can make the different structures of the electronic configurations, and we have to also add this part of the electronic configurations. Thank you.